So in this session, we'll be discussing more about what is accounts and how to maintain the accounts and what is money management. By now, you have already learned how to build your own civil engineering team, right? So I think you people are very confident now to build your own civil engineering team. If you are having any doubts related to it, please put it in our Facebook group. I am here to answer you. And also you can ask questions related to it in the Q&A session, which we are going to start very shortly. So in this particular session, we will discuss first about the labor and material management. It is very, very important for a civil engineer to maintain the accounts and money management with respect to labor and material, because the prime factor to complete the project is the labor team and the material supplier team. So if you have a good skilled laborers and if you have the quality material supplied, so the final product will be awesome, correct? So we'll just see here what are the things you have to consider. So to do this material and labor management, okay, to keep that accounts and all those things, you can do a simple MS Excel sheet, okay, wherein you will be having one sheet for labor and one sheet for the material management. So you can have a simple Excel sheet, update it every day, what material has been brought to the site, what has been consumed, how many laborers have worked to the site, for example, mason, male helper, female helper, carpenter, and what exactly the wages you are paying. All those things you can maintain it using a simple Excel sheet. You don't need any kind of very high-end technical software or something like that, okay? You can use this MS Excel sheet. Next, payment voucher. What is a voucher? A voucher is a form wherein you will be making the person to sign in that voucher for the payment you have made. Because in most of the civil engineering projects, we will do the payment in the form of cash, okay? In the form of cash, because the client will give us the cash and we'll do the payment similarly. If they give the check, what we'll do, we'll sign the check and we'll give it to the labor or the material supplier. What happens, we'll be having the accounts for it. We can just take up the bank statement and we'll be having the accounts. If you are giving it in form of the cash, what you can do is, you can maintain a payment voucher wherein the person who is actually taking the cash from you, he'll sign the voucher. We will be writing his name, the amount in words, and the purpose of giving the amount. Okay, that is about the payment voucher. Next, competitive rates in the market. Like, you should make a survey properly before finalizing your labor and material supplier team, because there might be certain situations wherein you will get a very good skilled labor at a very low price. Okay, you can save a very huge amount of money in your project. Similarly, the material suppliers also. Depending upon the quantity of material you are going to buy it, you can ask the material supplier to give discounts on it. Correct? When you have taken the project on your own, the complete material project of giving the building turnkey, in that situation, what happens? You will be benefited as an engineer. Correct? So this is about the labor and material. So most of the people are very much confused about GST and income tax with respect to civil engineering field. So as it is happening with the other field also, here also we have to pay the GST and we have to show the income tax. So here what happens is, when we are going to buy the cement or steel, okay, the person will give us the bill. So what we have to do, we have to give that input tax. We are going to give the tax to the supplier. So he is actually giving us the tax. Like, he is collecting tax from us and he is paying to the government. So same bill, we are giving it to the auditor and we are billing that material to the client. So the GST, whatever we have paid to the government through that material supplier, that we are taking it with including certain profit, okay, from the client. So for the extra profit, what we are going to declare, for example, if we have purchased 100 bags of cement, each bag of cement is 300 rupees. So we have paid 30,000 rupees inclusive of the taxes. We have billed the same cement for 310 rupees for the client. Okay, so it is 31,000 rupees. So in this situation, for that 1,000 extra, only for that you have to pay the GST. The remaining GST will be credited back to you. Like, you have already paid it, you are not supposed to pay again the same GST back in the GST forum. Okay, you have already paid for the 30,000 rupees, only for that 1,000 extra profit you have to pay the GST. So what happens here is, this is the expense. That is, you are buying material and you are utilizing it in your site. So for this material payment, whatever you have got it from the client, you will not be subjected to any income tax. Okay, the income tax will come only for that 1000 profit what you have got in that cement billing. You have shown certain profit there, correct? For that 1000, you will be given income tax depending upon the scale, in which scale you are going to come. So I'm just briefing you. There is a lot of things to understand in GST and income tax. Okay, so you have to be, you should have an auditor. Okay, you should consult him regularly when you get the project. He will guide you properly how to collect the taxes and how to pay all those things. Next, cash or check payments. So you should come to a conclusion very properly with the client that whether he is paying a cash amount or the check payments for the construction. Because in our construction field, most of the construction activity will take place through cash itself. Okay, but if you are taking cash also, how to utilize it? If you are taking check payment, how to utilize it? So when you are having the auditor, you can consult with him and he will guide you properly. GST registration. It is compulsory for everyone to get GST registered. Okay, go to your auditor, tell him I am starting this business. He will tell you where, what all the things has to be given. Accordingly, you can get the GST registration done. Then bill books, invoices and voucher. So you should have the bill books properly maintained. The voucher, whatever you are going to give it to the labor or the material suppliers. And invoices, like whatever the material supplier is giving it to you and what the invoice you are going giving it to the client, all those things you have to maintain a file properly with respect to each project. I'm repeating it, with respect to each project you should have a separate file, or else it will be a very difficult situation for you to bring everything to a proper way. Okay, the basic agreement with the client. Why agreement is required with the client? If you are doing a small 30-40 site, okay, the project cost is 50 lakh rupees, for example, it's a very small amount, but still you should get into an agreement. Why? Because the whatever the materials you are going to put it, for example, you are putting UltraTech cement or Mysem cement or Ramco cement or ACC cement, you are going for Indus Steel, Apex Steel, Tata Steel, whatever you are going to put it, as per your quotation given it to the client, has to be shown in the agreement. First part. Second, whatever the basic rate you have put it, for example, cement, you have put the basic rate at 350 rupees delivery at the site. Okay, steel 55 rupees kg delivery at the site. If due to certain economical disturbance happen and the prices goes very rapidly to the next level, the steel will become 65 rupees, cement will become 400 rupees. In that situation, what happens? If you are having an agreement, it will become very easy for you to fight with the client. You can tell him properly that yes, it has gone very high, so we have mentioned the basic rate. So if it is a very small variation, 5%, 10%, you've already mentioned it in the agreement, we would have handled it, but it's gone very high than that, so we cannot handle it. So the difference has to be paid by the client. Similarly, with respect to the flooring tiles, if you have quoted 65 rupees basic tile, if the client selects 80 rupees, the 15 rupees difference has to be paid by the client. So all these things will be mentioned in the agreement. Along with that, the schedule of payment, we are going to discuss it now in the next phase. So even that will be mentioned in your agreement. Each agreement is to be registered. Depending upon your trust with the client, you can register the agreement. If you trust the client very much, so agreement cannot be registered, not required. But for certain amount of project, you will be having certain bond. Okay, the amount of the bond equivalent to that amount will be there. You can consult with your lawyer. He will tell you properly the format of agreement and all. Then you can do the agreement. I suggest you people to go with an agreement with the client, because in my 10 years of experience, we have not agreement. We have not get into any agreement with any clients till today. Okay, the projects which are we are starting from now, we will be 100% getting into an agreement. Even the project is of 2 lakh rupees, 3 lakh rupees, whatever it is. Because I have lost huge amount of money in my career. Okay, this is my experience I am telling you to people. Please get into an agreement with a client. As a consultant, whatever the service you are giving, get into an agreement, get the work order from him, then only start the project. Okay, so you will not be in a kind of any kind of suffocation. You are not going to face any kind of suffocation in the future. Next, schedule of payment. What is the advance you are going to take? What is the stage-wise payment you are going to make it? So when to stop the work or slow down the work in the progress. So these things are the very critical situations that comes in your life as a civil engineer or as a service provider, as a consultant. For example, you are doing a structural design of a very big, huge apartment. You just imagine you are doing a structural design. So what happens? The client will pay you the advance. If he has not paid, you are not going to start any project. correct? You'll be come with an agreement that yes, we will be doing all these things stage by stage. We'll be giving our drawings, all those things you'll be telling it to the client. Client will release the work order to you. According to the work order, what you will do, you will start the work. So you will mention this much will be the advance to start the mobilization. Like you have to set up a team and you have to initiate the process and all those things. Documentation and all will be there. So advance is being paid by the client. Next, stage-wise payment. When we release this drawing, this amount has to be paid. When we release the third stage of drawing, this amount has to be paid. So if that stage-by-stage draw amount, if you collect it properly, there will not be any problem you are going to face in the future. Or else what happens? You will be releasing the third stage, he has not done the payment. You will be releasing the fourth stage, he has not done the payment. You will be releasing the fifth stage, okay? Still, he has not released the payment. What happens? You'll go under frustration, okay? Because of which you cannot give the quality to the clients. End of the day, what happens? The relationship will go in a very wrong way so that you won't get your money back. And the client will tell in a negative way that this person is not working properly because of which I have not paid. So he will do the negative review for you in the market. So at that situation, what you can do, you can stop the work telling some reason, okay? Not the payment reason, telling some reason, you can stop the work. First thing, second thing, you can slow down the process. Okay, when you slow down the process, what happens? The client will ask you to release the drawing. You can tell them, sir, we have already got the advance and work order from the other client for whom we are already working because he has paid the advance payment more than what you have paid. We have already released the drawings for you for which you have not paid the complete amount. So we are just slowing down and we are rapidly giving the drawings to the other client. So by telling all these things, you can control the client and he will give you your payment. So this is about this session. Guys, please get into an agreement with the client. Get the work order from the client. Get the schedules of payments properly. Maintain your accounts using simple Excel sheet. Nothing else. Simple Excel sheet. I'll be discussing that Excel sheet in Q&A session. I'll be taking half an hour to 1 hour of that how to maintain the Excel sheet and all. I'll be telling you people in the Q&A session. And how the material prices are varying. How to be controlled. All those things we'll discuss in the live session. Wherein you can ask the questions there itself. I'll be answering for it. So this is about the accounts and money management. We'll see you in the next session. Thank you.